quite nice having the 8 weight today. Beautiful fish. Go out of here. Ridiculous. Off he goes. A very lucky strike. What have we got down the end here? I reckon be a rainbow. Oh, be a brown, I think. Maybe the head shake's going on. Another one. Oh, rainbow. Every time the fish hits the edge, they don't like it. Should have extended it. To the depths it goes. Alright, I'm pretty sure there's a couple more on this lip. I think they're all across this lip looking in those shapes there, because that's what it took before. So we'll see how we go. Previous cast when I caught the rainbow, I was still getting line out, just fishing inside. Didn't really expect much, so seeing as I already fished it earlier before I got before I started covering the lip, didn't really expect to get a fish there. Yeah, there's a two fish on the lip by the look of things moving around, just in the way in front of me. Oh shit, it's gonna go in between the two of them. Let's see what happens here. Yep, take that downstream, down to the pool, should I say. Get tension on the line, and we're in bizzo. Quite nice, this actually has a bit of current in here, because it was just a big still pill. It'd be almost impossible to, well, not possible, just they have a lot more energy. Just, you're not using the current to fight them. I think this is a slightly better fish. No, just little clip of it too. Whoa, jeez. That's the gravel. No, it's just another 2 pounds. I keep putting the net away for some silly reason. Alright, 3 fish. Oh, hold on. No, I've hooked 4. Then I started filming. So, first fish I dropped was a little bigger than. Oh, I'd say they're about the same size as these little things out here. There's a few more shapes, and I haven't even really covered the lip. I'm just fishing inside at the moment. So you can see all the way across there, I've only fished the first few metres of it, so we'll see how we go. I think there's a couple more out there, I think. See the just touches, which means I think I'm finding fish, just haven't connected. Don't really need the indicator, just I hope it makes it a little bit easier for everyone to see the end of my fly line, because that's really what I look at. It's only when I film that I like to use an indicator, just because otherwise people go, what the hell are you striking? Get him over this way a little bit. Oh, this fish has a bit more grunt, but then again he's into that current on the far side. Just want to get in this big pool where I'm pretty sure there's no snags down here. So, 5 hookups from 1 pool. You really can't complain about that. But all these fish are a lot bigger than all the fish I've been catching today. So most of the fish I've caught today out of this river have been about 1 pound, which is very strange, seeing as some of the fish I've caught out of here have been in excess of 5 and 6 pounds. So then again, I usually only go fishing here early season. That's when I'm able to get away and get down this part of the country. So I don't really know where the big fish are. I'm assuming I've found some cooler water because it is rather warm today. Might be a little bit cooler over in this corner of the river. And all of this little performance from the 2 pound rainbow. See, he's been peaked on the side. Lovely 2 pound rainbow. And he's wanting to get out of here, which will get him out of here. Let's see. Alright, five fish, and I have really only covered the first third of this lip. There it is, probably the most promising side. I'm always debating going over, getting my 6 weight, rigging it up. So it's been rigged up all day, sitting on the bank over there, and putting a dry on and just seeing if they take off the surface. So so yeah, very public spot. The whole reason I chose a spot like this is I'm all looking wounded at the moment, and I really can't walk very far. So done something to the ball of my foot, really sore. So there's a big shape out over there, which is a fish. There's a couple of other shapes inside of that, which is a fish. So I really want to work my way along. When I used to be a bit greedy, I used to try just go for the biggest fish, which would be fine, but it's always a good idea to work the inside all the way out, just so you don't spook them all the way across. Very healthy river, especially this climbing with all the weed. There's a shape inside of it which I really want to fish first, because there wasn't one previously, but they will be moving around because the bigger fish had a bit of a swerve, might have spooked some out of a different position. Bit late on that. There must be a fish there, because that was I didn't expect there to be a fish there, seeing as I was fishing it well and truly inside of the target. As I get closer, so I'm just trying to keep the same length of cast, otherwise I'll cover something I shouldn't be covering. So I'm just using a 12, 13 foot leader, just the standard rig. It's a bit shorter than I'm used to, but it's a bit more in contact, and so I don't miss any of these smaller fish's strikes. Oh, well, even if that was a fish, wasn't the target, but it was a fish. So, oh well, on to another one. There's a target right in front of me. Probably got spooked off the bar. It's moving its way across. It's a small fish. Hopefully I can release this guy fairly easily. Small fish singleways, I always think struggle with. There we go, that's what I want. Cool. Right. Play with my drag, just sometimes plus your thumb pressure plus everything else, it's always a good idea to have it set just right, otherwise you could have some dilemmas. it there, I can see it. Good fish too. Right on the lip, riding it. But there's a couple of shapes. It's always the case. I think the big fish just keep pushing across. Oh. Let's see the small fish. As small as I thought it was. He's about 2 pound. But it looked like a 4 pounder out there. Not quite ready yet. As now. Poor little thing. Get your way down here, away from everything else. Alright, go this way. Come on. Oh, it has to be a fish because that's a deep drop off. Leaders well and truly over it. It must be a small fish nipping it. Don't know why I haven't got a good connect. Moving across, so just started to move across the slip. Amount of fish about, I'm just going to strike on anything that not quite what I was expecting, but I'm on. Right, yeah. Feels like 3 pound on this current. He'll tire himself out, so. Oh, that's no good. I feel like the most awkward fish to catch because they're so small, they flip around a lot, and they're really hard to hold on to because you don't want to hurt them. And then in the net, they just hurt themselves and cause a mess, so. Okay, so off he goes. You know, and just think about all this water out here, and I can't actually get a decent drift out there just because it's just too big, too slow. And I'm nowhere near the bottom. I'm only fishing the real, you know, the top third of the water, even with double, you know, I have three bead heads on this rig, and it's only been the top third of the river. Oh, there's a fish, and that's a good fish too. I'm gonna say that'll be pushing 5.5 pound. I could be wrong, but he's ahead of the lip, which is really pain in the ass. I'm well and truly inside of him. About 3 meters inside of the net, that drift. Could be a brown, which would be quite fun. There it is. Might be exaggerating with the 5.5, but it's a decent fish, if it is a fish, that is. It looks like it's weaving around. Could be just a bit of weed. Drifter is voluntarily inside of it. Bit of a hard drift because I've got a curling current. I see a fish. Might be taking it. We didn't take it? Yep, we did. What's quite strange is the fact that he was on the surface, came up, and then he went shot forward, even though my line was past him, and then I managed to hook him, which is very strange, but he obviously doubled back and got something. So he's 3 pound, big as a brown before. I think. Okay. Doesn't look too bad. He's gonna shoot off, I guarantee it. Oh shit, actually, but guys, running low on battery and space on my card because I didn't clear it, and yeah, I only got a couple of minutes left, so I think I've hooked that big rainbow. Well, not big, but you know, big-ish. Saw it drift across, struck before my indicator went down, because just saw a big flash of the mouth. And I'll just drift them over here. The big rainbow? Brown? Yep, brown. I'm access to my camera. Well, I think I just scraped my leg with my hook. What a disaster that was. Let's just come down here. Oh, I thought he was a bit bigger than this, but hey. A fish is a fish. Let's get him away.
Beautiful.
See, in the water he looked way bigger than this. On the lip. He'll go sulk for a day or so. The thing about this rod is it doesn't, even though it's an 8-weight, it doesn't feel like I'm over muscling the fish. Like if you get a 5-pound, 6-pound, they 7-pound, they still feel the same weight as this one over, you know, it's 3 pounds. So it's really useful. You can tell there's power, but you also, because it's got a soft tip, you can you know, you can play the smaller fish and not feel like you're being too brutal on them. This one has a ton of energy, but then again, it's right up top, so. Well, I'm always going to call it home, but I really do want to see one more pull, because I've been here before, so we'll just see where we go.